Guys, I have got a lot of requests for this video, and thank you so much for putting those comments and those suggestions down. I have a Honda-powered lawnmower right here with a fixed throttle on it. How do I turn the RPM up on this, the speed up on this, so it's running faster and it's running safely? There's a lot of guys out there who say you can't do this. There's no adjusting screws on there, nothing like that. Well, yes, you can. Thank you, April. Apparently, I'm going to show you how to do this right now with a little help from my good friend, Mr. Grolsch. Welcome back to Steve Small Engine Saloon, guys and girls. Thanks for coming back. Hey, if you guys do have any suggestions for videos that you want to see me do, I got a little link up here in the I button, the information button. That'll take you back to my website, stevesmallengine.com. Fill out that form, hit the submit button, and I'll see what I can do for you guys. Now, I know you guys all really want me to get to the point on this one. Show us how to do it. Hold on a second here, you guys. There is some critical information here that I need to share with you guys. There, if you YouTube search what I'm doing right now, how to adjust the RPM on this Honda-powered lawnmower, I think it's either the top two or the top three videos that come up with guys showing you how to do this. They're telling you to adjust your governor, literally a fine-tune your governor on that. Guys, please do not do this. This is misinformation. This is incorrect. Sorry to say to the other guys out there doing this, this is not how you adjust your RPM. At the end of this video, I'm going to put up a little thumbnail. It's a clickable thumbnail that goes back to the video that I've already done on how to adjust the governor properly on this thing. And then you guys see that after this video, you'll understand a little bit more about what I mean. So I'm going to show you how to do this right now. It's a simple procedure. Don't sign off after I just show you how to do it, because there's other important information you guys got to stay tuned for. Like, how do you know what the RPM is actually running at, and what RPM should it be running at, what's too much RPM, all that kind of stuff. I'll show you that in a minute. This is how you do it. If you look here, this is your governor arm. The governor arm goes all the way down here like this, and that's it. This is your governor spring right here. That spring is what makes your RPM go up and down. It's pulling that arm back and forth to open and close your carburetor. We're not going to go into quite that kind of detail right now. The point is, the tighter this spring is right here, the faster your RPM is going to go. Pair of pliers, needle nose pliers is what I use. It's just easier. Here's the top of your governor arm. Hold that with your fingers like this so it can't move. And then grab the governor arm on the bottom right here, and then if you want your RPMs to go faster, you turn this counterclockwise. Turn your pliers counterclockwise and watch what happens to this spring. That just bent that arm out, and now that spring is way tighter. The tighter that spring is, the faster your engine is gonna run. Same thing if you think it's running too fast. You just do the same thing, hold it, and you bend that back like that, and now that spring is slack, it's loose, it's going to be running way slower. That's how you do that. So now that you know how to do that, how do you know what RPM it's actually running at? The only way that you know this and get peace of mind for sure is with a little digital tachometer like this. These are not that expensive, you guys. I know that I'm using a Steel EDT-7 right now. They're about $100 to buy one from your local steel dealer. I have a link in my description that'll take you back to a place where you can buy one of these things that do pretty much the same thing for $20-$30. They're not that expensive, guys. Easy to use. All as you do when the mower's running, you just hold that real close to your spark plug. like that, about half an inch away or something like that. And it just automatically picks up the RPMs and reads it out on that little digital display right there. So now that you realize now how you can actually read the RPMs on your mower, how fast can we actually get this thing going? How fast can we actually make it run safely? This is the only one that I can find that actually tells you an RPM spec. It says maximum speed 2950 to 3100 RPM. That is how fast that thing is allowed to go right from the manufacturer. So why did we just do that? Simple, guys. The faster your engine runs, the faster your blade turns, and the faster you're gonna cut grass. It's just like that. Give me that thumbs up button, guys. I hope you liked it. I hope I was clear and thorough enough and I didn't leave anything out. And share this video with your friends. There's a lot of guys out there that have these engines that need to know that. Subscribe to my channel if you already haven't. And throw some comments down, guys. Put some comments down on this video and let me know what you thought of it. And don't forget, there's that little clickable thumbnail coming up right now. Take you back to my adjusting the governor. Check that one out next. Till next video, guys. Steve out.